It makes me feel really excited. There's something magical about touching a real object. You can do any number of calculations on paper, and you can see what it will look like on paper, and you can do renderings of these things, but there is no substitute for coming and touching a real live energy bag. Today we're going to see some energy bags, and I've been talking to you for some time about these things. These are a way to store energy in the form of compressed air, ultimately in the sea. But I'm going to show you two prototypes that are not in the sea. They're in the beginnings of a tank. This tank is going to store 17 tons of water in a laboratory here. Our health and safety man is very worried about the insurance implications of that, but it'll be fine. These are the two bags. So I don't have names for them yet, but I'm trying to think of what would be a good name. These are made from a combination of really quite special materials. The materials used here are probably too expensive to use for the seabed application, but our first priority here was to demonstrate that we could make them at all. They feel a little slack at the moment. They're not containing a great deal of pressure. The rated pressure is 4/10 of one atmosphere. And to your listeners, that won't seem like much pressure, but that's the difference between the pressure inside and the pressure outside. So if you put these 500 meters deep in seawater, then that's 4/10 of a bar difference between inside and outside, but outside is already 50 times atmosphere. We start with a primary energy harvester of some description. The best of those is a giant wind turbine. And this wind turbine compresses air by having parts moving internally inside the rotor. The compressed air comes from the rotating part into the tower of the wind turbine. It's brought down through ducts and it comes down to the seabed, and you have to picture this is the seabed. And in fact, to get this picture right, you have to really consider that that point is tied down to the seabed via an anchor. And in this case, the anchor is just onto the bottom of a tank. In reality, that anchor would be onto a very large piece of ballast. And so this whole bag is pulled down, has very high pressure water all around it, so that what the bag has to do itself is just to keep the water out and the air in. That's an easy job, just surface does that. And also withstand the buoyancy force, because when you put this in water, there are 2.5 cubic meters of air inside here, so you get 2.5 tons of lift force that has to be pulled down. And that lift force is held inside these very special members. So how it all works is you pump this full of air. When you want your energy back, you let the air back out. It comes out through, in this case, rather a slender pipe. That pipe isn't fit for service yet. This is just for demonstration purposes. We need a bigger pipe in service. The air comes back out through this pipe, runs along the seabed a little bit, and then rises back up to the surface and goes into an expander to turn a generator and make your electricity when you want it. The key word in all this, dispatchable electricity. So in a nutshell, these bags enable you to store the energy until you need it. Some of the air that comes from the wind turbines gets expanded directly, and only that bit which is spare goes into storage. With this system, you lose only about 10% of all the energy you put into storage. With most energy store systems, you lose more than 20%. Well, it needs to be sealed around the edge with a sealing pack. Okay, so this is the beginnings of a tank. It's got a steel framework. It has to hold inside it about 17 tons of water. In order to test these bags through their full range of operation, these bags are going to be cycled inside the tank, emptied and filled. When they're empty, they'll turn into a very slender shape that will rise up nearly to the top of the tank and just have a bulb at the very top. And when they're full, they'll be approximately this shape, but pulled down to the base of the tank. They won't be exactly this shape. They'll be more pointed at the bottom because the water is trying to lift it all up. The tank has acrylic sides. It's 25 millimeter thick acrylic. It's going to look nicer than it does now because there's a protective covering on this acrylic. So this will look quite a pretty fish tank, and people are already calling it Garvey's fish tank as we speak. These sides obviously are yet to be mounted, and we need, additionally to what you see here, a little piece of external structure, because acrylic is quite expensive. So we've bought acrylic that can be bought reasonably economically. It's 25 millimeters thick, actually not strong enough to withstand all that pressure over that area. So it needs an external push to stop the acrylic from coming out at us and letting the water on the laboratory floor. We don't want to waste a lot of energy here. So what we really want to do is not keep on compressing air from scratch and letting it loose again. We're going to cycle these bags. So one is pressurized at any one time, the other one is slack, and the air is going to cycle between the two bags. Still use a bit of energy in that, but it's for the interests of something that's going to save a lot of energy, so I think that's justifiable.